So I decided to play a bit of Formula One Manager 2022, and I'm just going to run through one race, you know, just to give my thoughts and opinions on, you know, what I think about the game. Now, you're probably thinking, hold on a sec, Alfa Romeo, and you have Max Verstappen and Lando Norris. What? I was actually playing around with some modding of this game, and I might release a tutorial video showing you how you can actually mod the game yourself. Now, how I like to do this, I like to take first practice. I usually sim second practice, and then I usually take third practice or manage third practice. We're going to stick the hards on for both drivers because I don't want to use all my softs up. I know we have to randomly give Pirelli some soft tires after each session, I believe. But we give him a setup within the greens, and then we'll see how we go.
And ready to check.
Yeah, confirm.
Track should be green now.
Now, I have also modded the tyres, the grip amount for each tyre. So the softs, for example, will degrade a lot quicker than what they will in the base game, which I find makes two-stop strategies a lot more viable. That's why I went with that. And I also lowered the intensity of the DRS.
So just on the way in, if you give us some feedback on tools and what we can look at.
Yeah, we're just too slow.
Okay, practice session one over with. We were not looking at times because obviously we was on the hards, so that's not what we was using that practice session for. Oh, one tip is that if you have like a reserve driver that you want to rank up high, but if you let your reserve driver drive in practice session one, it will help them level up quicker. Right, so the heavy rain for the race. So looking like we're going to be on the wets. So we're going to simulate the first session of qualifying because, you know, we should get through, hopefully. Unless something goes wrong, but we should be good. Yeah, so we're fifth and seventh. But Max with his new front and rear wing, that's why he's outpacing Russell and Hamilton. But that's what I was hoping. I was hoping those wings could get us that little edge on Mercedes. I mean, catching like the Red Bulls is difficult. Like, it's so hard staying behind a Red Bull. And like Ferrari, they just absolutely zoom off. We've got the same engine, of course, but the car has such a better setup. I'm going to simulate quali 2. Nice. So both in the top 10. I think this is the first time they've both been in the top 10. Lando usually drops out in Q2. So get them both on the U-softs, run them into the ground.
Ready.
Everyone good?
Yeah, ready to check.
What matters, because obviously this is their flying lap. What matters is when they get round to here, how many cars come out. Like, I hate it when your driver gets round to here and about five like people come out on the run. Not the best. But, you know, we've saved our tires, so we're going to get them on now. Let's put these tires on now. I'm not going to send them out yet. I'll probably send Norris out first. So wait for all these cars to go, and I'm going to bring Norris out at the back of these cars. So wait for Bottas to go. Right, Norris is going, and then wait, and then Max is going to go now. This is make or break time. I mean, Max is fifth at the moment, but people are going to be on their faster runs now. Hopefully Max gets round in time. I think his lap started already, right? Does he have to get round? Yeah, he must do. Right, Norris is on his run now. And Max is going on his run now. He's ahead of Sainz, which is good. Right, okay, Norris improved. Nice. Can Max improve? Oh, he does.
Yes.
He gets fourth. So now, that's it. Everyone's done. Wow, what a run. That worked out perfect. So Max is now fourth. Norris is seventh. Now, that's actually a really good qualifying session. But Max absolutely flew on that last one.
Drivers are strapping themselves in, ready for race day.
So around lap 18, we are going to be seeing some rain. Got a fresh set of mediums, so we're going to send him out on them, and then we're going to see how we go. So we're actually going to put him on no strategy, just send him on the mediums, let him race. Whereas Max, on the other hand, because it's pointless to send them on the hards, right? If rain's coming lap 18, hards are just going to be slower, so we can absolutely tear into the mediums. So what we're going to do with Max is we're going to put him on an aggressive setup. We want him absolutely flying out there. So give him full overtake, pace mode aggressive. I mean, we could even go attacking, but we go aggressive. Do we overfuel the car? Because if he can keep up with the Ferraris, like on pure pace, by the time the rain comes, we should have a good gap over like the Mercedes and the Alpines. No lift or coast, just go. Just don't crash. But Max is aggressive, right? He's not going to crash. I'd never send Lando out on this setup. That would just be suicide. Lando's going to be a touch more conservative, but I will give Lando overtake. Right, let's go. Exciting. Exciting times.
We have beautiful blue skies overhead as the drivers line up on the grid. Taking a look at Max Verstappen. They might not be in the top three spots, but things could change fast once the race gets underway. Norris there, further down the grid. They're in the front half of the pack, so there's plenty of potential for them. The race start is mere seconds away. Get ready for the Australian Grand Prix.
Right, let's go, let's go.
And it's lights out, and away we go.
So we want to be on Max straight away. So there's Norris back here. Go on, Max. Okay. Looking good. Yeah, Max is on his tail. He is stuck to the back of him. Just what we wanted. Norris is looking good. Okay, come on, Norris. Up the pace. He's getting away. Come on, Max. Those Red Bulls are so quick. So our weather report system isn't the greatest, but it's not too bad. I think we're up at like 70-80%. I think it's 70%. So obviously we've got a Red Bull behind us, so it's going to be tough, but it does put in a fastest lap. Yeah, Verstappen's, he's struggling. Oh, here he goes. Oh, Max. Get in, nice.
DRS enabled.
Right, we've got to harvest a bit.
Good stint so far, Max. Keep at it.
Nice.
Recharge on, please.
Yeah.
But, I mean, staying with the Ferrari is going to be tough. It's going to be so tough. Yeah, they are just rapid.
Overtake is available. Overtake available.
Come on, Max, just stay with those Ferraris.
Okay.
You know, they can tow us along.
On the battery.
Yeah.
Okay.
No battery. All good though. How close is Norris now? Okay, Norris is 0.3, but he does have Hamilton behind him. See, he can't really take his foot off the pedal.
Last lap was a purple
Max
lap.
Is flying.
Okay.
Go on, Max.
Nice job, mate. Nice job.
Oh, well done, Norris. Norris got past Alonso finally.
Okay.
Look how quick those Ferraris are. It is crazy how fast
they are. Well,
it's got the fastest lap again.
We're now at P7 at the moment.
DRS zone here as well. That's what I love about this track is you've got two DRS zones, one after the other.
Gained for Mercedes.
Yeah, Hamilton and Norris are just going to keep switching positions, which is fine.
Take available if needed.
Go on, can you get him on this lap? Go on. He's too quick. And Mercedes is fast.
Max.
Oh, hold on. Max is absolutely flying. He's just past the Ferrari. And he's not using battery.
Position gained for Alfa Romeo.
And we can have recharge on, please.
Cool, Max. He is flying. Yeah, he did all... Bottas is faster, but... Leclerc's faster as well, but... He's just getting that DRS, I guess. You know, we've stuck to the Ferraris as long as we can. We're going to have to start saving some tyres. I mean, once that drops to 50, I'm gonna put it to standard. This is my first race with rain ever. Yeah, Max has lost out to the Red Bull, which again, expected. There's not really much we can do about that. Norris is having a pretty bad race, to be fair. Okay, light rain. Track is dry still at the moment.
Looks like that was a position gained for Alfa Romeo.
Nice. What up, Max?
We'll box this lap, please.
Box, 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 box. I think we're going to get Norris in on the intermediates as well, because we've got quite a few laps of rain coming.
And box a slap.
Yeah, confirm. Happy to box at the end.
That's right. Anyone else coming? Yeah, everybody's coming in. Oh, Ferrari's have stayed out. What? Leclerc stayed out. That is interesting. Okay, they've gone into the inters as well. So the Red Bulls have gone full wets. Leclerc has stayed on the medium side. What is...
Oh, should have we gone full wets?
We need to see the lap times between the wets and... So who's on wets up here? The Red Bulls are on the wets. How is Leclerc still on the mediums? Surely he's coming in this lap, right? What is he doing? Yeah, okay, Leclerc's coming in. I was going to say. So yeah, so look how much time Leclerc lost. We're actually ahead of him now. What a terrible decision. I mean, it's typical Ferrari, right? Typical. But what does Leclerc come out on? Does he come out on the inters? He does. So that's interesting. Because us and the Ferraris are inters. And Red Bull are on wets. So what are we looking at lap time? Yeah, look at the Red Bulls. They're almost a second down. So at the moment, Red Bulls are on the wrong tyre, in my opinion. But could it work out long term? Right, we've got to make the most of our tyres. Because if we're a second quicker a lap than them. Yeah, look at their lap times. We are way faster. We need to get ahead of these. Come on, Norris. You need to overtake them. Maybe because that was because of the pits. Just moved up a place. But we are faster. We are definitely faster. I mean, Leclerc now is 13 seconds behind us. That is crazy. Oh, come on, Norris. You need to take Hamilton. What are you doing? Yeah, you need to take Hamilton and quick. Nice. So now Bottas is a second behind us. I mean, it doesn't matter because obviously no DRS, but we are creating a gap between us and them. Oh, no. What do we do here? What do we do here, guys? There's no two ways about it. We should have put the wets on. Red Bull made the correct decision. Yeah. We messed up, but not as much as Ferrari did. They messed up a lot worse than we did. So you're going to want inters for like this spell. The trouble is the inters won't last that long. Like we'd have to put a fresh set of inters. So we should have been on the wets here. And then as the rain stops, switch to inters. So now the question is, how much time are we going to lose on the inters compared to the wets? Because what's a pit stop going to cost you, what, 30 seconds? And if we're losing like a second a lap, I guess we're going to be losing. Yeah, science has gone in for the wets.
All right, just stay focused.
So do we put the wets on? The thing is Leclerc going to come back in? Because Leclerc's now on the inters. So if he comes back in, it won't be too bad. Because science has just come back in. So science will go ahead of us, but he won't be too far ahead of us. I mean, Norris is just... I mean, Norris, he's having the worst race of his life right now. And we are not helping him, to be fair. Yeah. Do I bring... Yeah, I'm going to bring Verstappen in and put the wets on.
Box and pit confirm. Box, pit confirm.
You let me know what you would have done in this situation because I haven't got a clue. So I'm really interested to know what people would do here. So Leclerc's in, yeah. Leclerc did come in. So let's get Norris in as well, I guess.
Boxes lap, boxes lap.
Where is Norris? Yeah, he's coming in now. Yeah, we messed up, guys. We certainly messed up. But what can you do, eh? What can you do? The good news is Verstappen is still fourth. Leclerc's in, Norris is in, Tsunoda's in. Yeah, everyone's coming in for wets. Well done, Red Bull. Well done. Good decision you made. Because now, look, they're 14 seconds ahead of Sainz. Yeah, they did well. They did well. They made the right choice. But, I mean, imagine if we'd put Max on the wets. Imagine where we'd be right now. I mean, that is typical Ferrari, right? I've said it already, but it is. Poor Leclerc. Right, recharge your battery anyway. Let's get some... let's actually focus now on the race.
Okay.
So this is a weird race now. Like, everyone's been shuffled around, but, I mean, we're fourth, right? We can't be too unhappy about that. I mean, it's been a great race so far. It's just that one mistake we made with the tyres that could have got us up, like, in second, third. Because we would have definitely been ahead of Sainz. You know, and then could we battle the Red Bulls? That would have been the question, which we probably couldn't have. But, you know, we could have got third. So, at least, you know, we only dropped one position for our mistake, which isn't the worst thing in the world, to be fair. Okay, apparently Norris ran wide. Yeah, you see what I was saying? Because I've got him on aggressive. Like, he's just not as good as Max. You know, Max is born to race aggressive, but... Lando, you know, I'm not so sure. But I was hoping he could close the gap on Russell, but it's just not happened. It's actually grown. He's actually got further away. So what can I do with Norris? I mean, he's going to get a point in 10th. But yeah, unlucky Nando. He's had a terrible race. He's actually had a terrible race. Whereas Max, on the other hand, had a great race. We've actually got some side pods coming as well for Max's car and a new chassis. So this is that patch where we're going for a little spell of light rain. Oh, okay. So Hamilton has pit. Why has Hamilton pit? Bottas has pit as well. So a few people are coming for inters with 18 laps to go. So you know what? I'm going to bring Norris in because he's got nothing to lose, right? Ricardo's like 5 years behind him.
Okay, Lando, we'd like to box this lap. I'd like to box this lap, please.
So if I bring him in for the inters?
Yeah, I confirm. Happy to box at the end.
He might be able to get some speed. Maybe catch Russell that way. Because look, Magnussen's like 34 seconds behind him. So Norris has got a free pit stop. Now I can't bring Max in, obviously, because Leclerc. Perez has pitted as well. So Perez has come in for the inters. So Max is currently third. So he's got a podium. He can finish here. But the truck... Oh, Russell actually came in. Okay, Russell pitting as well. Unfortunately, Russell...
Okay, understood. And just remind you, use the pit limiter in the pit lane.
Like, pitted the same lap now. If we had pitted Norris the lap before, then he might have had a chance to take him, because obviously that is out lap. Now the question is, we need to watch the laps. We've got some fuel, so we're going to push on the fuel as well.
We do not require any fuel lift off.
Okay.
So this is what I was thinking about with Max, is that if the rain comes again, you know, we're on the perfect tyre. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens, because, yeah, that rain is going up now. So the track could go wet again. And all the cars on the inters? Bad news. Yep, there we go.
We are out of DRS.
So track is now wet. Okay. So who is on the inters? So the Red Bulls are on the inters.
Recharge on, please.
The Mercedes are on the inters. Yeah, because now, look, Perez is falling behind. Now the track has gone wet. So, okay, Norris is on the inters.
So, recharge on.
Yep, confirmed.
But I'm trying to harvest some battery for Max so he can catch up to Bottas, which he is doing. Now, if we look at the rain, it does die off around lap 48, 49, sort of 50. So if we can gain some ground in that time... then we possibly could take, because look at that, Perez has fallen 4 seconds behind us. So we got a lapped car ahead of us, and then Bottas, I believe. Yeah, so it's going to be an interesting end to the race. Yeah, that's a lap car. And now we are going after Bottas. We had 0.8. So we're 0.7 behind Bottas now. Come on, Max.
Recharge on as well, please.
So Red Bull messed up here.
Okay.
Yeah, the Wets is the far better tyre at the moment. Far better. Yeah, track's drying out. Rain stopped. Yeah, see, now the Inters are going to come back into play. So the Wets have had their little time. Now the Inters are coming back into play now. So yeah, we're not catching Bottas, I don't think. The question is, will Perez catch us? I think I might pit Max. There's no more rain now. There's like light rain. But that's not going to make the track go wet, right? So the track's going to be damp now until the end of the race. Okay, Max is coming in for his tyres. And the good thing is Max will be able to push on these Inters. You know, then we just hope. Yeah, so we lost out to Leclerc, which was expected. But I'm hoping now we can catch Leclerc. But what I love about the rain is you've got to really think about it. Really adjust your strategy to, because obviously you can't be switching from wets to inters. Like, you have to pick a tyre and you have to stick with it. Now, I think the perfect strat would have been to go straight onto the wets and then switch to the inters. That would have been the play. Yeah, here we go. We're going to do Leclerc easy. Easily do Leclerc. Give him a bit of overtake to get the job done quickly. Yep, there's Leclerc. See you, buddy.
It's a good stint so far.
So that's why I switched Max's tyres, because, you know, he's lost nothing. Perez would have took us anyway. You know, just it gives him more tyre, because his tyres were like, what, 60% when we brought him in. So there's no good leaving him hanging. And nobody else is on wets, just the Ferraris. Ferrari have had a terrible day. Terrible day for Ferrari. I mean, Hamilton could catch Leclerc at this rate. So bringing Norris onto the Inters, you know, was a good move in the long run. The trouble is the Mercedes did it as well, so we didn't really gain anything there, which was a shame.
5 laps remaining.
Oh no, changed to wet.
So think about the liftoff.
Yeah, we're not going to do it now. Heavy rain at the end. We gave it our best shot though. I mean, what a day Red Bull have had though. What a day. I mean, the decisions were pretty much perfect every time. They just always made the right call. We messed up slightly, but other than that, I think we've done okay. I think it's been a good day for us all round. I mean, Norris had a terrible drive, so Bottas takes first. Perez is taking second. Sainz couldn't catch Perez. The rain come a little bit too late. But what a great race, though. That was such an interesting race. I'll tell you what, the rain is exciting. It gives you so many decisions and it changes like the race a lot. But massive race for us as a team. Huge points. 12 points. Beautiful. So where does that put us? That keeps us fourth, but it gives us so much ground. It's a shame that Norris had such a bad race, because like they ended up getting only 1 point less than what we got. And that was all because of Max. But there you have it. There's my video on F1 Manager 2022. If you liked it, hit the like button. You know, whether I bring more of this or not, I really don't know at the moment. But thanks for watching, and until next time.